I'm Zsolt Slavica. I'm here at Johannes Kepler University in the Linz School of Education. I'm a professor in STEAM education research methods. We are using lots of 3D printing in our projects because we believe that this will be the future and an integral part of everyday life, and then it will be used in many different forms. Many of our projects are connecting different subjects, and then also within these subjects we are trying to integrate 3D printing and then also 3D modeling and augmented reality and virtual reality.
Hello, my name is Markus Hohnwater. I am the founder of JKU. JKU is a mathematics software for learning and teaching. It's used by more than 100 million people all around the world, students and teachers from South America to Europe to Australia. The software has been translated to more than 60 languages, so it's a tool that's really widespread in lots of classrooms out there. So JKU is a tool for visualization. We started out with 2D because many times in mathematics a picture says more than 1,000 words or equations. And one problem that we have seen is particularly with students understanding 3D objects. So while we're trying in JKU to also have 3D visualizations on the screen, we have found out that it's much better to do something in the real space. And 3D printing is a wonderful way to take what you see on the screen into reality, into real life. And this is now allowing teachers and students all over the world to really take their mathematical models into their hands and explore them in a much more natural way. So when you're doing 3D modeling in mathematics, you oftentimes have the problem that it's very difficult to imagine, for example, cuts of an object on a screen. In this 3D game from the Logifaces project, we have created these mathematical objects in JKU, and students are now able to really put the puzzle pieces together in real life, which helps them with understanding cuts of mathematical objects in a much better way.
I'm Matthias, I'm from Uruguay. I'm doing my PhD in STEAM education here in JKU in Linz. My students here, the pre-service teachers, we are designing games together to bring to schools. This game is called Genius Square. So you need to throw the dice and you will get some coordinates, like let's say A2. Now the game consists on placing the pieces, like look like this Tetris pieces, so you need to somehow place it on the square, completing the spaces. So this is basically a tic-tac-toe but more complex. So in order to win, it's the same, you need to make three on a line, but of course you will have the problem that someone will put different colors or will try to do lines in a different level inside. But you can explore a lot of different things, and of course different classification with the pieces, and explore with the small kids like how to classify different shapes and size and colors and play with it. And of course it has a lot of logic inside it, like the original game, but with more depth and complexity. So the idea with this was very simple contest. The idea is to divide the cube in different pieces that has the same volume. Having this 3D graph in your hands gives you a lot of ideas about how the function will behave. It's actually a very interesting idea for teaching mathematics. I'm actually participating in a project for blind students, so also working with the printed models of functions to teach functions to the blind students that cannot actually see the graphs in the screen, so they can touch it and feel it and get an idea about what we are talking. Exploring 3D printing, it's a very good way for them to visualize objects and very abstract objects in mathematics, and having a good picture of what we are talking about in the mathematics classes. So I think it's the tool that was missing some years ago. Before we had JKU, we had the computers, but having something in your hand, it's a completely different experience, and it's really important. We know it from mathematics education research that having different views of the same mathematical object is really important to understand it. So 3D printing comes here to save us. I have tried a lot of printers. I've been working with 3D printers for some years now. I bought a cheap one when I was back in Uruguay, and I had the experience that sometimes in the class we had a problem with the technical side of the 3D printing. So it was really hard. You need an expert teacher to use it. But if now we are trying this, the Prusa printers, and we are getting a lot of very good feedback from the teachers. They are not asking us for help with the technical part. They just put the file in, push print, and get what they want. We were trying the Mark III before, so we had some experience with the Prusa printers from a few years back, but now we had the feeling that's even simpler. So you don't need to calibrate the machine, you can move it around, just put it in a place and print, and that will work. So I'm having a really good experience with the MK4, yeah. The input shaper, it's a life changer. I think I'm saving hours of my life every day just being able to print, I don't know, 60% of the time or something like that. In a big print, we sometimes do very big games to take to the schools or fairs or something like that. If we didn't have input shaper, probably it will take like weeks to get something done, and now we can just do it in days. For us, using the Prusa filaments has been really good, because it's also some very simple step for the teachers in the school. They just select the profile in the slicer. They don't need to do any adjustment. Everything is calibrated, it's perfect. They don't need any extra steps. So for our experience with the teachers in the school, having the filament that works perfectly with the printer, it's the best option. We just started with our printables account, and we already had some very interesting comments. Actually, we had some people attending the conference online from the United States that got in touch with us through the printables account. So there's some excited people around the world looking at what we are doing, and we are very happy to keep sharing, and we will keep posting our things there and getting in touch with the community. If things keep getting easier and easier for the teachers, we will see definitely printers in the schools and more teachers using it. And we are having more and more ideas now that we have teachers using the printers. We are collecting new ideas for the classroom. And I think in 5, 6, 10 years, this will be like a computer in the school. We will have a room with some printers, and every teacher will be able to use it, play with it, teach with it. So I think we are moving in the right direction.